some background so essentially everything I say is classical, meaning more than 20 years old, except when I will quote some theorem of Mochizuki. And so a basic notion is the notion of harmonic bundle. So my first task will be to define what it is. And I would say that the first time I saw the notion if work of Simpson, I found it very strange, so I will try to explain where it comes from and what it's good for. But first, some linear algebra. So if you have some real vector space, will be a tangent space to some manifold, you can consider the complexified dual, so things to complex value at one form on a manifold. So here, this is real. Now, if you have in addition a complex structure on the same T, this, which is the sum of R linear map from T to C, breaks into two pieces. You have the linear map and the antilinear map. So you have this part of the complexified dual of type 0, 1. That means linear. And the part which is antilinear, this is the meaning of 0, 1. And one way I like to think to it is that if you have a structure of complex vector space, in particular, you have an action of the group C multiplicative on T. And this action will extend to an action on any object derived from T. And here you will have action by Z inverse, and here by Z bar inverse. Now you can also take the exterior algebra. And now you will have a decomposition that the nth exterior power is the direct sum of exterior P of this T1 0, tensor product exterior Q of this T dual 0, 1, P plus Q equals N. And so this will be called the path of type PQ, and here the action of this C multiplicative is by Z minus P, Z bar minus Q. Okay, so that's the linear algebra. Now, if you have a manifold which is complex analytic, by definition, at each point, the tangent space has a complex structure, so you can have this story, and you will have that the space of n form, complex value at n form, a canonical decomposition in omega pq, which corresponds to the decomposition I had here, and in local coordinates, section of this omega n are function times some product of dz's and dz bar with p dz and q dz bars. And important is that the Durham differential decompose into two pieces, one which map omega pq to omega p plus 1 q and the other to omega p q plus 1, and it's clear in local coordinates. Next, if you have a complex vector bundle on X, and just now I don't remember the analytic structure, just a complex C infinity vector bundle on the space X, then one has a notion of connection. And if you have a connection, I don't assume integrable, it is extend canonically to maps omega n v, so omega n tensor v to omega n plus 1 v, with the, yes, the connection is something which satisfies delta fv equals df v plus f dv, and for the extension you want nabla of f alpha, a form times a section of v is d alpha v, and now a plus of minus alpha nabla of v, where this plus of minus is minus 1 at the power of the degree of alpha, because we use switch this derivation across a p-form. Now, if you are in the complex analytic case, you can also speak of connection either in the d prime direction or in the d second direction. So this is something which we call either nabla prime or nabla second, to v going to omega eta 0 1 or 1 0 of v, with the and you have the same formalism. It extends to a map from omega n v to omega n plus 1 of v. Now, in this case, because of this extension, you can consider the curve at for nabla 2, which is product with two form with value in endomorphism. You have the notion of zero curve at for, meaning that you get a complex. And this is the case of flat bundles. Now, in the case of nabla second, I prefer to look second first. You can also consider this notion of curve at first equals zero, and this is a complex structure on V, meaning turning V into a complex analytic bundle, with the holomorphic section being those which are killed by nabla second. There is one way I like to picture this. This fact that it's a complex structure is not completely obvious in the general case, but if you assume everything is complex and is real analytics, then it is completely obvious. Because if you have some real analytic variety, you can always complexify it, find it as real locus, if I may say, of a complex analytic variety. And if you start with X, which is already complex analytic, this complexification is a neighborhood of the diagonal in X times X bar, where so the holomorphic function on this neighborhood are holomorphic function of the Z's in those coordinates and the Z bars in those coordinates. and so you see that if you complexify, you have two natural foliation corresponding to one coordinate constant on the other. So I think I will put x here and x bar there. And now connection in the nabla second direction is just a connection, an integrable connection, sorry, a connection is a connection on each leaf, and it is integrable if on each leaf you have an integrable connection. So in this case you can pass to the quotient by the Fourier, and you get x. You have the complexification of v, which is a complex vector bundle on this neighborhood, and passing to the quotient you get v again with the complex structure defined by this nabla second. Okay, so that's the linear algebra. And now I am ready to give the definition of harmonic bundle, which at first will look very strange. At least it did for me. So today we have X as before, complex analytic. The definition so far is local. You have this infinity bundle V, and you give a connection in the prime direction, a connection in the second direction, a 1-0 form with value in endomorphism, and a 0-1 form with value in endomorphism, which I call theta bar, but it's in no, so far it's not in any meaning the complex conjugate of theta. You just have this with this in omega 0-1 tensor and V, and here you have, 1-0, and here you have 0-1. So you give those two things, and each extend in a natural way to the Ram complex with coefficient in V. I have explained it for the connection, and here you just multiply by a one form, and you have, so it's a one form tensor endomorphism, you multiply by the one form, and you apply the endomorphism. But now the conditions, rather strange, is that for any complex number A and B, you want some integrality condition. So you look at A d prime plus theta bar. So this is, in a way, 1-0, and this is 0-1, plus B theta second plus theta. So this is a map, is something defined onto the Ram complex, and you want square equals 0. So for so those A and B are the same as the Z and W of Goncharov, but I don't know if it is Z and W or W and Z, so I have preferred to call them A and B. Now, what does this give you? Of course, you can expand, and then you have three conditions, that the square of this is 0, that here you have a square 0, and then some cross term, which is 0 also. But so first you can take A equals B equals 1, and in that case, you just get that V is a flat bundle. This sum with A and B equals 1, that just nabla for some flat connection on the bundle. Now I want to take just B equals 1 and let A vara. Now, I can separate, this was convenient to write it like this to at the beginning, but now I will write it rather as A d prime plus theta plus d second plus A theta bar equals 0. So I have just rewritten this for B equals 1, but writing the term in some other order. And again, this will mean that the square of, this is the part of type 0, 1, this is the type of part 1, 0. So the square of each would be, would vanish, and also a cross term would vanish. Now, if you look at this, this is just a connection in the d bar direction. So that's the complex structure. So for each value of A, you get on your bundle the structure of a complex analytic bundle. Now, on this complex analytic bundle, you have this, and the fact that you have the cross term vanishing will tell you that this is holomorphic connection. Cannot be holomorphic because it cannot be connection because it starts with A times D prime. But you can take this and divide it by A. So you look at D prime plus theta over A. And so this will be holomorphic connection on this holomorphic bundle. But it's better to also allow A to be zero. So one will tell that on this holomorphic bundle, one has what one call A connection, meaning something which satisfies lambda A of FV equals A, everything is holomorphic, F and V, A of DF times V plus F times lambda. So the usual Leibniz formula, except that you use A times the differentiation rather than the differentiation. And if you look at this divided by A, you get just an holomorphic connection on this holomorphic bundle. But the reason not to divide by A is that it makes sense to take A equals zero. And in that case, what you get, you still have your holomorphic bundle at A equals zero, but now you have just one form with value in endomorphism, and you have also the condition theta square equals zero. So for form your harmonic bundle, for each A, you get a vector bundle with A connection, with a particular case of when A is equal to zero, where you get the X bundle, that is vector bundle homomorphic plus a map V, linear map V to omega 1 tensor V, whose square is zero. So in this way, harmonic bundle give you a way to go from a flat bundle to a X bundle. And there is one more thing which is easy to check, is that if you don't take a fixed value of A but let A vary, in fact you will then you can consider D in the direction of this new value. Then you have something if you want on your space time the line with coordinate A, you have your infinite bundle V, which is a pullback of something from X. For each point here, I told you that one had some holomorphic bundle, but in fact one has an holomorphic bundle on this product, with the condition that if you fix a point here and take a constant section, it will be holomorphic, for each constant value, constant point here, for each vertical, I told you that the complex structure is given by this D bar. So you get something interpolating a flat bundle with X bundle over this affine line. So here one sees something a little annoying, is that I understand what happens when B is 1. No, it does not make much difference to replace AB by a multiple. So for B equals 1, one has something nice. So for B is not 0, one has the same thing essentially, but we don't cover the case where B equals zero into the interpretation. And now what one can observe is that if you have such an harmonic bundle on X, if you go to the complex conjugate analytic space. So if you want the same space but the holomorphic function are the anti-holomorphic one, and on it you take the complex conjugate vector bundle, this will again be an harmonic bundle, except that A and B are exchanged with B bar and A bar, so the D prime and D second interchange and theta bar interchange. So if you have both X and X bar, you get some understanding of all possible ABs. So that's the definition of harmonic bundle. Now I have to define what is a polarization. So a polarization will be an Hermitian form on this complex vector bundle with the following property. First, if you take d prime plus d second, which is a connection on this bundle, it would respect the holomorphic form. So parallel transport along some curve in using this connection will respect the Hermitian form. And in formula, that can be written as follow, that you have, if you have two sections, d prime of phi v w will be equal to phi d prime v w plus phi of v d second w. So let me check this makes sense. So this is you have those two sections. This is a 1-0 form. Here you have a 1-0 form tensor section, which you pair with w, so you get, and the Hermitian form is linear in the first variable, so you get 1-0 form. Now this Nabla second is a 0-1 form, but it appears on the antilinear side of phi, and so this expression will again be a 1-0 form. And you have the same, but one implies the other with second, second, and prime. So that's the first condition. And the second condition is that if you look at theta and theta bar, they are adjoint to one of the other. So so this is something like dz times an endomorphism, and here you want a dz bar times the adjoint endomorphism. And what this means, if I write it in the same way, is that 0 is equal to phi of theta v w minus phi of v theta bar w. So no, this is the adjunction formula. This, if you put theta in front of v or theta bar in front of w, you get the same thing. But I had it in this way to emphasize that here I have a plus and here I have a minus. And this alternation of sign is crucial for everything. Now I can express it slightly differently. The point is that, so if I give myself the harmonic bundle structure, here I have defined polarization. Now, if I give first the flat structure and phi, then I can recover the prime, the second theta, and theta bar. Of course, usually it will not satisfy the axiom. Something will not be integrable. But those formulas enable one to recover to all those components from the Hermitian form and the flat connection as follow. You can think to the Hermitian form as an isomorphism between V and the dual of the complex conjugate vector bundle. So if you have a connection on V, flat connection, you by this isomorphism If I have a connection on V, automatically I get a connection on the complex conjugate dual. If I have this isomorphism which is given by phi, from the original connection I get back a new connection. So I have the original connection nabla and I get a new one with the basic property that d of phi v w is phi of nabla v w plus phi of v the new connection w. So now what you the way you recover all those components is you can take nabla plus nabla u over 2. This will give you d prime plus d second, and you can take nabla minus delta u over 2, and this will give you theta minus, theta minus theta bar. Plus of minus, I have to check. So, because you have opposite sign here, this is what allows you from the flat connection and the Hermitian form to recover all those components. Yes, and now when you have this, you can take the 0, 1, and 1, 0 component, and you get. But of course, usually, this integrality condition will not be satisfied, and it is a condition on this that it. So, if you start with D and a Hermitian form, you get all of those, and you have. One will say that if one gets an harmonic bundle, one could find an harmonic metric for the flat bundle in question. Now, I should explain this word harmonic. And
nabla is not holomorphic, right?
Sorry?
Nabla is not holomorphic.
It's flat. The V is here just the infinity bundle. And so if I had an harmonic bundle, I had a flat connection, the one with A equals B equals 1. And now I have this. Now, if it is flat, it is holomorphic if you want. But by connection, I mean the infinity connection. So V, the differential of a C-infinity section of the bundle is the sum of a 0, 1 form and a 1, 0 form with value in V. Now, let me suppose that I am in the case of a curve. And I have my flat bundle V. So, infinity bundle with a flat connection. So, having locally, it means that this is just something constant. I can use the horizontal section to say that locally, I have just V is the space of map from the curve to a fixed vector space V, with the constant function being the horizontal sections. And in this language, having Hermitian form on the bundle means having an Hermitian form depending on the point of the curve on this bundle. So I have a map locally from the curve to the space of Hermitian form on some fixed vector space. Now this space of Hermitian form, this space of Hermitian form, positive defined, is a Riemannian symmetric space. So one has a Riemannian metric, the only one which is somewhat Vénéus for action of GLV. And because of that, it makes sense to speak of harmonic map from the curve to this space of Hermitian form. The definition being that if you look at integral of I look now as my phi as a map from the curve to this Hermitian space, it has a differential and I integrate the L2 norm of this differential. It looks at first that I use a Riemann metric on x in writing this, but in fact I don't, because I can tell I have d prime, d second, and this give me a dz, dz bar form. And one wants that the variation of that be zero, so extremal for this integral. And the condition that that d and phi, in the case of a curve, give me an harmonic bundle is this extremality condition. Now, because the space of a Hermitian form is negatively curved, one can hope for existence of such a harmonic map. Of course, the situation you have a flat bundle. Let me suppose now x is compact. Now you have this local system of V, you have this local system of Hermitian symmetric space, and you want a section of this Faber bundle with this harmonicity condition, and because you have something negatively curved, you can hope to have solution. And in fact, the theorem is that if you have a flat bundle which is irreducible, a flat bundle that's essentially the same as a representation of the fundamental group, and you want this representation to be reducible, then there is such a harmonic metric, and it's unique up to a factor. And more generally, if you have vector bundle with flat connection, which is semi-simple, direct sum of simple, then again you will have some Hermitian form, just write at a sum and take the sum of each, but in addition it's unique up to automorphism of this flat bundle, so it's as unique as possible. It will be known if the bundle is not semi-simple. Yes, now it's more complicated in the higher dimensional case. You have many more equations that something like this, and also even to write this in higher dimension, I would need to use the some Gaylor metric on my variety. But on a compact Gaylor variety, it's still true that for something irreducible, I have essentially only one Hermitian, harmonic Hermitian structure.
I'm sorry, I'm going back, but why did you say that on the curve the element of integration was obvious?
Ah, so let me write this a little differently. It would be the same, but d prime z, d prime phi. Now, this is here I have a 1-0 form with value in the Tanzan bundle of my Riemannian symmetric space. Here I have again a 1-0 form. So taking both, and but this is until. No, I need the second, sorry. Now, if I pair the Tanzan space, I get a 1-1 form with value in scalars, and I can now integrate a 1-1 form.
So you integrate that intrinsically?
Sorry?
It's intrinsic.
Yes, it's intrinsic. Because I am in dimension 1. In higher dimension, it would not be true. One first has to prove that they are, if one take a Gaylor metric on a compact variety, they are some harmonic in this sense, Hermitian structure on the bundle, and then that automatically it will satisfy all the identities of an harmonic bundle. So that's work of Simpson of 40 years ago about. So you have so you have plenty of harmonic bundle and many things which can be done in Hodge theory can be done also for cohomology with coefficient in the flat bundle. Essentially you have get some Gaylor identities and it works similarly here. So again you look at cohomology in terms of harmonic form and miracles appear as in the Gaylor case for plane cohomology. Now, this still, for me, the definition remains a little strange, and so I want to explain the motivating example, which that variation of odd structure giving a natural way harmonic bundles. And first I will recall the, I first need to recall what is a variation of odd structure and tell it in the way which is adapted to this. And for that I would first tell what is an odd structure, so I recall now some Gaylor geometry. So suppose X is a compact Gaylor variety, and I will tell what is Gaylor variety later. Just now you remember it is Riemannian, but there will be other conditions. And also any projective algebraic variety is Gaylor, as a Gaylor metric. Now, the cohomology of X with complex coefficient, or real coefficient as well, is the cohomology of the, so you take the Durham complex of X and you look at closed form modulo exact form and that gives you the cohomology. Now the miracle which happens in the Gaylor case, I had told you that For a complex variety, the multiplicative group C multiplicative acts on its Tanvan space, on even on its real Tanvan space. And because of this action on the real Tanvan space, it acts on each component of the Hamm complex. And the miracle is that this action gives an action on cohomology of this same group, the multiplicative. Of course, not in a completely naive case, the differential is not compatible with the action of the group C multiplicative, but there will be enough form so that both the form and its transform by this action are all closed. This means that enough form which are d prime and d second closed, so that to fill the whole cohomology. And also, if you have such a d prime and d second form, closed form, it will be homologous to zero if and only if it is d prime d second of something. So if you write the cohomology as the space of d prime and d second closed form modulo d prime d second exact, then clearly there the action of the multiplicative acts. Not a way of telling it. If you take any cohomology class can be represented as a sum of class of type form of type PQ, which are each exact. And so this action of the multiplicative gives you a decomposition of the cohomology into HPQ pieces, where HPQ is those cohomology classes which are representable by a PQ form which is closed. So that's the definition of, and so one abstract from this definition, the definition of an odd structure. So an odd structure, say of weight n, one thing to hn, is first you have an integral lattice, that's the integral cohomology. Then if you complexify, you have a decomposition into hpq pieces, with the condition that HPQ equals HQP complex conjugate. And one way of thinking to this decomposition is that it's an action of C multiplicative. And for instance, the action of I in C multiplicative acts by I minus P I Q. So I would say I Q minus P. So you have some I if n is odd, and then you have alternating sign on successive HPQ. So that's odd structure, and now you have the notion of variation of odd structure. And here the definition, I should first tell something else. Yes, no, I have first to tell a few other things before speaking of variation. The way I presented things like this is that you may observe that the statement I have made, it's true only in the Kähler case, but the metric did not appear at all in the statement. So sometimes one presents odd theory by telling that one represents the cohomology by harmonic form, and the PQ component of an harmonic form are again harmonic. This is indeed a way of one proves that there are enough d prime and d second closed form, but this decomposition of the cohomology holds in the Kähler case, but does not depend on the particular Kähler metric which is used, because this description of it does not use the metric. Now, if I want to explain the notion of polarization for an odd structure, I need to use a little bit more of the metric. What you have is that if you consider this Hermitian form and then this the imaginary part of it, this is a two form of type 1-1, that it is a form expressed thus that phi of xx is equal to 0. Sorry, it's real. So the imaginary part is 0. And this makes it a two form. And the Keeler condition is that this two form is closed. So in particular, from the Keeler metric, you recover some cohomology class in H2.
I'm sorry, going back again to this construction, is there a better choice of square root of minus 1 or you choose 1?
I prefer not to use a better... No, here... No, there is not a better choice, but when I will tell what a polarization is, the choice of I will occur in two places which cancel each other. No, indeed, it would be immoral to have to use a particular I, because you can make complex analytic geometry over one algebraic cluster of R, you don't need to fix I. So, to explain what polarization is, I will need this additional information on the coming from the Keeler structure. And the basic theorem is that if you take an iterated cup product with this class, and if n is the dimension, it gives an isomorphism from Hn minus I to n plus I. And again, the proof is to show that this is true on the level of harmonic forms. But does not require, the statement doesn't involve only the corresponding cohomology class. Now, let me try to picture what this means. So, I had on the blackboard the cohomology groups. First, I have H0 with C. Now, in H2, I have C eta. In H4, I have C eta square until C eta n in dimension n. So, this is now next, I have the H1, then the image of H1 by eta until some power. Next, look at H2. You have already a part of H2 here, and I want some supplement to what I have already. Now, the way to find a supplement is to look at those classes, which when I move it them up to here by cup product with eta, they vanish. Because if I take anything, maybe it does not vanish, but I correct with a multiple of this one, and then it will vanish. So this is the space of primitive form, primitive classes, whose image by eta at the power n minus 1 vanish, and then I have the same multiplied by eta square, and so on. And now I continue to do the same. I have some supplement of, in H3, I have a complement to what I have already. defined by some vanishing condition, and I have a succession of isomorphic things. So this is picture of cohomology, and all those lines look like representation of SL2R, and indeed that's how one would think to them, with multiplication by eta being the 0, 1, 0, 0 element of the Lie algebra SL2R, and the grading was given by the diagonal matrices. Okay, now the parallelization story is that if you fix a primitive part like this, first let me be in real cohomology, then I have a natural bilinear form, because this maps isomorphically here, and those two people are in duality. So, and I have an isomorphy between something and its dual, that's a bilinear form. And if I want to go to the complex, I turn it into a Hermitian form. And now the point is that this Hermitian form has some positivity property, but which involved this AQ minus P, which I will call operation C. And the property is that this has a sign. Sometimes positive defined, sometimes negative defined. I have to check my convention. Maybe sometimes it's I times a positive number or I times a negative number. But you have some sign. And so that leads to the definition of polarization of some odd structure. You want to have some you want to have some bilinear form phi, so that if you look at phi of x cy bar, this is Hermitian positive defined. And this psi will be alternating for an odd and symmetric for an even. Okay, so that's notion of polarization, and now I can tell what variation gives me. What is a variation? The model here is that you have your x, some y projective and smooth family over x, and you take here the local system of cohomology of the fiber. Now, so if I move a little in x, it's always essentially the same. The cohomology of one fiber or a Nibar fiber, that's the same. I have a projective and... Oh, sorry. That's what I should have written. And each HI, X as a decomposition into PQ pieces, and one has also such a polarization form. And now what one has is that if I look at the sum for P bigger or equal to A of the HPQ, this subspace of essentially a fixed vector space varies holomorphically. If the complex conjugate, which is the sum for Q bigger or equal to something HPQ, varies anti-holomorphically. And in addition, one has Griffith's transversality theorem, which tells that if you take some section of this subbundle, and you take the derivative, you don't stay inside this Otfiltration subbundle, but you get only in the next bigger one. So you have that if you take D of something in VPQ, you will be only in the AB where A, you get only one to the next. So this allows you to decompose the, the D of the flat connection you have into a piece which map VAB, sorry, VPQ to VP minus 1 Q plus 1, one piece which maps to VPQ, and one piece which maps to VP plus 1 Q minus 1. This is a connection, possibly not integrable, and this will be, I will call it d prime plus d second. This piece is here you have just a d prime, so here you have, and this is linear because you go from VPQ to something else, so this is a 1-0 form, and this is a 0-1 form. And note, basic theorem is that if you take this d prime plus d second plus theta bar, if you take all of them, you get an harmonic bundle. And so I should explain why it's true. I mean a polarized harmonic bundle. So I would say that if I have a variation of what structure, I get those quantities. I can consider a positive diffeomic Hermitian form which is my polarization form, like this, and this will be an harmonic bundle and a polarization of the harmonic bundle with one additional property. An easy exercise is the following. If you have an harmonic bundle and you have u complex number of absolute value 1, so u bar equals 1, and you put here multiply by u and here multiply by u inverse, which is the same as u bar, you again get an harmonic bundle. And it's again polarizable, and you have the same polarization, polarization at the same Hermitian form. Now, what is happening for having harmonic bundle with a polarization, the point is the following. If you look first of the form psi of xy, which is an horizontal form, which is what you had on integral cohomology and then extended to complex cohomology, this will be a sum of pairings on the HPQ. Because the pairing psi pairs HPQ with HQP, and so it becomes a sum of self-pairing of each HPQ. And now when you do this, you replace this by the same times, by a sign which alternates with P. And what you add first is that if you look at psi, then it is the connection respect psi. It will not respect this modification where you put plus or minus depending on the component. And this is the reason that you keep this, but you get this as the other part. I think I will not do the computation, but it's this alternating, of sign which explain what is happening there. And now a theorem of Simpson is that if one generalizes a little bit the notion of variation of odd structure, one gets exactly to the polarizable harmonic bundles whose isomorphism class is fixed by this action of S1. Yes, it's rather clear that what we have obtained here is fixed by the action of S1, because you have the various HPQ, you have the D and D bar which map each to itself, you have the theta in one direction and the theta bar in the other direction. And now if you take the same thing, but you multiply theta by u and theta bar by u inverse, the two will be isomorphic by using as is isomorphism here one, here u, here u square, here u minus one, and so on. And one knows that u is of absolute value one to still have that the new theta and theta bar are adjoint to one of the other. Okay. Now, what does one want? If one considers what one wants to look not just at variety and their cohomology, but cohomology with value in some local system. And on a compact variety, it's quite nice to have cohomology with value in a in variation of odd structure, but this is not enough. If you have morphism x to y and look at direct image, you will get something which is a local system on open P's and then there are singularities. So you cannot work only with local system, you need to allow singularities. And another trouble is that here I have all the time a pure odd structure. So if I take cohomology of a compact scalar variety, I get a pure odd structure. But if I take an algebraic variety which is not proper, then I will only get a mixed odd structure, something which has a filtration where successive quotients are pure, and plus something to glue those pure structures together. And the ideal for a good theory is that one has a six operation formalism, that one has kind of generalization of local system. One can take direct derived direct image, inverse image, tensor product, a home, extraordinary compact support direct image, and also vanishing circle. So this makes eight operations. So thanks to Moreika Sato, in the world of in the odd world, this is done. One has a notion of coefficients which are pure mixed D module, and all the operation works. And so one thing one wants, and which Takori Mokizuki does, is to have a notion something generalizing harmonic bundles but allowing singularities, and also having some weight filtration, so we need some mixed situation, so that again one has old operation one is used to in fifth cohomology. And there is one additional thing which for me was very surprising, is that here one has, essentially one looks at the analytic variety X with coefficient, for instance, in some local system. And here the way to express things is that one takes this variety X and one takes a vector bundle with connection, I will say an algebraic vector bundle with connection, and for instance if X is affine, the cohomology is obtained by taking the global section of holomorphic algebraic form with value in this bundle. Now, and one has a perfect correspondence between local system and such bundle if one imposes regular singularity at infinity. Now, this is in some sense an annoying condition because some of the easiest D-module have irregular singularity. For instance, if you take on the affine line just O and D plus DX as connection, then the horizontal solution is E to the power minus X, which is bad from an algebraic point of view. And here the Durham complex does not at all compute the cohomology of the trivial local system. You get zero. But this is a reasonable object still, and furthermore it has an analog in characteristic P with the Artin-Fraier fief. So this is the reason one wants to consider also connection with irregular singularity, or in general the module with irregular singularity. And that's the second thing that Mochizuki does. He extends the theory to the case of essentially irregular singularity. And one of the concrete theorem he proved is that if one has on some compact projective algebraic variety simple D-module, holonomic D-module, singularity can be irregular, and you define in a natural way the Ram cohomology. This Hadleffert's theorem I had quoted, that hi to h dimension, twice dimension minus I is an isomorphism, remains true in this irregular case. Now I think I would stop. I had plan to explain what is the meaning of this cohomology in the irregular case, but I would stop here.